sir. Big championship match scheduled today. That's the Southern Tag Team Championship. There's some ramifications that I'm going to get into in just a moment. Bill Dundee and Tommy Rich scheduled to go against Wayne Ferris and Pojo Yamamoto. Then we got the Dream Machine who will be here today. A brand new team called the Turk and El Suarez. And they'll be going against Copal Ware and Tom Bailey, plus lots of other things coming up right here on Championship Wrestling. Tell you what, buckle it up, get ready, and we're going to be back with our big championship action coming up in just one more. Okay, we're back, and I do, before we get into the ring with our championship match that's going to be coming up here before long, it's a special one called 30 Minutes for our television program. Want to make this explanation because there has been one example, a couple of examples, as a matter of fact, here and in other places some time ago. Due to the fact that they were trying to be reasonable out it, all the associations, WWF and AWA and NWA, CWA, the whole bunch, had a no-show rule on a championship match. That is to say that if a championship match was scheduled, that it would go on in fact. But there was the exception that if the champion did not, or rather had a legitimate excuse, like the fact that he missed his airplane or something like that, a legitimate excuse, then there was a postponement put in, and that was the way they tried to keep a reasonable attitude about the no-show, because, of course, there was so much travel involved in it. Then, as things would happen, and I think you've seen examples of this very thing, the fact that they started to abuse that no-show rule. And all of a sudden, all the guy had to do is the champion would say, hey, I missed my airplane connection, or my car broke down, or whatever it happened to be. And he doesn't show, and they say, well, I'll do this back. So they put in the no-show rule that under no circumstances could they void the championship action. I think you may remember the CWA heavyweight championship match. Austin Idol ostensibly had missed his airplane. But with the no-show rule, the title was taken away from him. And Austin Idol was stripped of his crown, and of course this was an effort to stop some of the abuse that had occurred over a period of time, and it seemed to be getting worse and worse and worse. We've got a similar situation to that today. We've got a Southern Tag Team title scheduled. It's going to be Bill Dundee and Tommy Rich going against Tojo Yamamoto and Wayne Ferris. However, some months ago, a couple of 3 months ago, Tommy Rich had made a commitment to the Atlanta, Georgia TV network to be there. The promoters had assigned this as a championship day here for the Southern Tag Team title. Rich tried his best to get out of the Atlanta situation. He was faced with a breach of contract lawsuit by the promoters down there because of the amount of promotion that they had made on it. And Tommy made the election that in this particular case, he was not going to be able to be here for the battle that should be taking place, and that is the Southern Tag Championship. Tommy Rich is not here. Bill Dundee is here, and I want to talk to Billy just a moment about this particular situation. And I know in a case like this, with the battle that took place for Bill and Tommy to get the Southern Tag titles, that with the no-show rule, it's kind of a difficult thing. Billy, I try to explain to people what the rule is, and I understand that it is a situation in your circumstance where Tommy could not be here. He had to elect rather than go through the breach of contract for him just not to be here, so I guess it's going to be a forfeiture on the belt today.
Unfortunately, Tommy isn't here now. I don't want to take much of your time, but I've got three choices. The first one we know is never going to happen. Jimmy Hart is the only guy who can walk out here and say, well, we'll wait for some minutes next week.
He's going to agree to the postponement.
And we know he's not going to do that. The second thing is I can take this belt off and give it to you and tell you to give it to Jimmy Hart. And I'm not going to do that. Tommy Rich and I fought long and hard. He stood up there and got handcuffed and whipped Stan Lackey from the bounty hunters to win the belt. That's true. And I'm going to wrestle for him. Now, I'm not going to stand out here and say I'm good enough to beat Wayne Ferris and Jose Yamamoto at the same time. But I don't have to beat them. They've got to beat me. All I got to do is just stay in there for 30 minutes. So we
did a special one for 30 minutes.
No, I'm not too hard enough to find any other thing. I can beat them both, because I don't think there's any guy alive can do that, but you have to beat me in 30 minutes, and I just hope they can do that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Billy, I have seen examples of it before, as a matter of fact, where one man elected to continue in a championship match and a tag match. It is not an selection has been made, at least certainly by Dundee, and we'll have to live with that one. We'll get ready for our opening bout here coming up in just one moment. The action coming up Tuesday night. I want to remind you that on Thursday, March the 19th, Campbellsburg, Indiana, where the Dream Machine, Chief Thundercloud, Superstar, Wayne Ferris, Tojo, Jimmy Hart, lots of others will be. That's Thursday, March the 19th, Campbellsburg, Indiana. And wrestling in LaGrange, Kentucky. That's going to be Saturday, March the 28th. Remember that. Put it down. Be sure you're there. Now, Tuesday night, a couple of matches in there you don't want to miss. One of them is going to have Superstar Bill Dundee and the Dream Machine. You'll understand all about this by the time you see Championship Wrestling today. And then they're going to be going against Wayne Ferris and Tojo Yamamoto. And there will be a match that will have Jerry the King Lawler going against Jimmy Hart, with Jerry Lawler having one hand tied behind his back.
Let me tell you something, Lawler. This is what I've been waiting for. I know I've said it time and time again. 10 stitches in my head, fractured jaw, torn calf muscles, or baby, that's going to be Jimmy Hart tonight. And as far as the Dream Machine goes, let me tell you something, Dreamy. Dundee, you're in surprise of your life, brother, because he is all talk and no action.
We're going to find out that on Tuesday night.
We're going to find out, Lance Russell. From now on, you refer to Wayne Ferris and Tojo Yamamoto as the champion. We are the Japanese Connection. We're the Southern Tag Team champion. And who did we beat? Billy Boy Dundee. That's who we beat. By himself with that big, fat, slob Dream Machine, who turned his back on Jimmy Hart, who turned his back on me and Tojo Yamamoto, the family. Dream, you never turn your back on a family. We got an oath in this business, and you supposedly took it, but apparently you took it the wrong way. You took Dundee's little oath, and that's to try to be around all the pretty girls, but we're going to mix your face up exactly like we did Dundee, and nobody's going to want to look at you, not one soul, and Jimmy Hart will never have you back.
Tuesday night, right in the garden. Well, as usual, a little hassle with Gypsy Joe. Joe in our opening bout here. We're ready for the introductions on it. On the right of the screen, making his first appearance on our championship wrestling out of Knoxville, Tennessee, coming in at 220, introducing Ron Sexton. Ron Sexton. His opponent today at 224 out of Romania, introducing Gypsy Joe. Gypsy Joe. Your referee is Jerry Calhoun. Here we go with our opening bout. 1 second, 50 seconds. Second out of Martin. front part of the leg, drop it down on you, Joe. Here's to the rules very closely. I can't say the same for Dixie Joe. And on the ropes, Joe stings him. He comes up again. Going for a choke hold, the referee. Starting to count at two. Joe cut loose of him, but he won't let him off the ropes. And now the referee is in between. Sexton popped in the eye, fired over. Goes right out, almost in the front row of our studio audience on Championship Wrestling. Ron Sexton on the floor, coming up on the four-minute mark with 11 minutes to wrestle. Sexton now back on the ring apron, but he's tapped by Joe before he ever gets into the ring. And Gypsy Joe puts Ron Sexton back on the floor again. Southern Tag Team title match coming up. It will turn out to be a handicap match if Dundee goes through with what he said. Whip into the turnbuckle, a knee to the midsection. Ron Sexton steals him out of the corner and pops Joe. Good drop kick. Joe back in the ropes. Says, hold it, hold it, hold it. He is underneath the ropes. Now he comes up. Broad arm catches Sexton in the midsection. Sexton on a leapfrog. Goes for a flying press. One, two, three. He got it. Ron Sexton. Leapfrog Joe as he went down for a backdrop. Came off the other rope with a flying press. Nailed him and got a three count in 4 minutes and 50 seconds. So the win goes to Ron Sexton over Gypsy Joe. We're going to take our timeout. We'll be back with Southern Tag Team action coming up in just one moment. Okay, we're about ready to go with the Southern Tag Team action. We're going to catch the challenging team before they get in the ring. We've already had the situation stated. Jimmy Hart, Wayne Ferris, Jojo Yamamoto. Jimmy, can we slow down the cheerleading a minute? Let me ask you this. Situation pretty well defined. You find in here Tommy Rich is unable to be here today, which leaves the options as follows: the fact that the Southern Tag Team Champions will forfeit the titles to your challenging team today. This is not going to happen. The second thing, Dundee has already said that he would wrestle against both of them in this special one-fall 30-minute championship match. But the third thing, and I ask you this, and I would give you some very good advice, that if you went in there today in a match and won it, the fans are not going to respect you. They're not going to respect the team or the win, even if they did take the time. And the reasonable thing it seems to me to do and good advice would be to postpone it so Tommy Rich can be back. Dundee and Rich can then defend against them. Nobody's trying to get out of the match, but I think that a postponement would be the very wise thing for you to do. You get a postponement on the match.
Oh, you really would? You think
I would advise you that if you want the respect that these men, I'm sure, are looking for is chances. If you can postpone it until you can win it, rather than just trying to beat one man.
You know what? I think he wants to postpone the match. Can you believe that? Russell, that's why you're an announcer and I'm a manager. Are you crazy? You know, if the fans didn't respect me, you know how much sleep I would lose over that? You know, actually, how much sleep I would lose over that, man? You have to be an idiot. You're a complete idiot. Let me tell you something, man.
Why don't you overlook the buck for once and do the decent thing about it and postpone it?
Let me tell you why. Because Jimmy Hart has worked hard all his life, man. I've been in Memphis, Tennessee my whole life. I've thrown papers. I've worked at sub service stations. I've had gold records. And for 14 months, I've been a professional rapper. And it's been the greatest thing to ever happen to Jimmy Hart. And you think, actually, that's what those rules are for, you fool, because of people like Dundee and Tommy Rich, man. I got a toothache. I'm sick. My wife's sick. I can't be here. You're an idiot, man.
He's not making any excuses. He got caught in the middle of a contract.
Oh, yeah, right.
And he couldn't be here today.
Well, I'll see what I'm going to do. Bill Dundee is a superstar. If he's a superstar, well, then let him get up in the ring and earn his status. He's supposed to be big macho man. So Dundee, come on up. The title match will be today, and we will be the new Southern Heavyweight Champion.
beat me by the skin of his teeth, but he whooped a lot of people. He also whooped Joe the Duke, he whooped Austin Idol, he whooped Jimmy Van, he whooped everybody. He whooped everybody. But you've been giving me the runaround for a long time, and now today, I can't believe what you're doing today. You've got this title match right here. I should be in there. I've been loyal to you longer than Tojo Yamamoto, longer than Wayne Ferris, longer than Dutch Mantell. I've been loyal to you longer than anybody, Jimmy. I've been with you since birth. And now this comes about. I can't believe what's going on. I'm tired of sitting inside you. You're playing with my head. You're playing with my pocketbook. You're playing with my money, man. Hey, I don't like it. And I want to know today, you know that Bill Dundee can't put two men. Can't no guy put two men. But I want to know today, when you change that match and put the dream machine in there where I rock it belongs. You change the match today. That's all I want to know. Are you going to change it?
Looks like the Jimmy Hart organization has a little disorganization. A little problem here and there.
Well, I tell you what, I don't need the big Goodyear blimp in here. He's been eating out of house and home, so who really cares? But let me just tell you right now, baby, you're looking at the next Southern Heavyweight Champion. So, Superstar Dundee, come on, pack your lunch, baby, and come on out, baby.
Well, it isn't over with yet. Remember this. I would bring to your attention the
gone with 28 minutes to wrestle, and Dundee again moves Yamamoto onto the mat. Still starting out very, very well. Ferris pacing up and down in the corner. Jimmy Hart keeping his eye right on Yamamoto. They had already put the belts around their waist. The important thing is the point that Dundee made. He doesn't have to win it. All he's got to do is keep from getting beat. He's got a 30-minute time limit, which, of course, with the TV stipulations on the 30-minute time, puts it at an advantage he wouldn't have if it were 1 hour. Bill, very cautious, head on, standing side headlock, Wayne Ferris. Had him, but Dundee takes him out over and down. Once again, referee telling Hart to sit down. Hart's up complaining about the use of hair, which Dundee did not do. Double leg dive. All right. Dundee trying to roll, going for a crab. Wayne Ferris resisting him in there. Tojo giving some shouts of encouragement. He's almost got him over, but Ferris still has that shoulder up. Billy gets up in there, but Ferris is awfully big. Dundee sits down on him, but Ferris kicks him out on a nice move. But they're over by the ropes, and that's going to take a tag, too. Tojo Yamamoto. As we pass the four-minute mark, with 26 minutes left to wrestle, Dundee holding up his end of it very well, and Tojo flexes those fingers, ready to got Billy's head wide open. Dundee bleeding now. He's hurt. That's what he had to stay away from. Barrett pulls him up. Nails him. Right in the left eye. Dundee down. Tag on Yamamoto. Referee moving Barrett out of there. Both eyes now. Jimmy Hart really feeling happy. Well, up to this point, he ain't really giving it a go. Using very, very good tactics. But Ferris stopped him on the floor. Dundee bleeding on both eyes. The Yamamoto methodically chopping him enough now. Coming up on the 15-minute mark. Hojo kicking. Dundee trying to kick at him. Caught him with one foot. Didn't catch him full. He's groggy. Bill trying to fight his way out of it. At the 15-minute mark, he's now halfway through. Battle is back on Ferris and Yamamoto. Dundee goes for Yamamoto. Then Ferris, the referee, trying to get one up out of there. Dundee pounding Ferris. Ferris down in a corner. He grabs Yamamoto on the whip. Nice drop kick. Dundee, who gave it a really valiant fight in there, 15-55, but he finally lost it.
Any man that won't stop anymore in his favor. something like that, I believe he's bigger, better, meaner, and dirtier than Jimmy Hart could ever think of that being.
Billy, why don't you go
you want to be me, Billy?
Why don't you go
and
clean up?
No.
We'll
prove to Jimmy Hart. I'll prove
okay.
you that I can whoop in a man in your
Let's
favor.
Take a break. Let's take a break, and we'll be back. Get to action right here on Channel 3 Championship Wrestling. We do want to get the entire card to you tonight. We've already talked about a couple of the matches, and they are worth talking about. So the opening match, Roy Rogers and Gypsy Joe going at each other. It's a tough feud. You'll get a chance to see him today. Stay tuned to the championship wrestling throughout. The Turk and El Toro will be going against Sonny King and Ron Sexton. Then Dirty Dutch Mantell faces the CWA World Heavyweight Champion Billy Robinson. Then comes that match you don't want to miss. I don't want to miss this one for a fact. A handicap match when the King, Jerry Lawler, faces Jimmy Hart. Lawler with the stipulation he will have one hand tied behind him. Then the final match is going to be a tag team action bout with Bill Superstar Dundee and the Dream Machine. That's right, just stay tuned for the rest of this program. Going against Wayne Ferris and Tojo Yamamoto with, of course, Jimmy Hart right at ringside. Tuesday night, Little Garden. Ready to go. What you're looking at is David Price and Jerry Calhoun. And here comes the big dream. All right, this will be a one fall, 15-minute time limit bout. Introducing out of Memphis, Tennessee, coming in at 206 pounds, David Price. And his opponent today, coming in at 273 pounds, the Dream Machine. Referee Jerry Calhoun, we're about ready to go. One fall, 15 minutes, no time. Off and running. Price going against the big green. All right, he takes right off, nailing Price, puts him down immediately. Kicks him in the air. Big body slam, the green. With a leg. Ooh, good night. He is so big. Big green really rattling him around, grabs the hair. The referee warns him, a whip into the rope. Big clothesline and Dream Machine. Just pushing. Wow, that's going to be it. I mean, in less than 35 seconds, the Dream Machine adds one last boot to David Price. And the Big Dream picks it up in 33 seconds as the Dream Machine, once he got into action in there, did not take him long, specifically 33 seconds. The referee, Jerry Calhoun, around to try to help David back up. He didn't know what hit him, and I don't blame him. That big 273 was really all over it. We do have, in fact, the Turk and El Flores, their first appearance on Championship Wrestling. We're going to be back to see it in just a moment. We're looking at a team that is totally brand new to us. Introducing first on the left of the screen, cut away to 463 pounds, introducing the Turk and El Flores, El Flores, and the Turk. And they're across the way, coming from Memphis, Tennessee, introducing Tom Mealy and his partner out of Union City, Tennessee, Coco Ware. Coco Ware. Referee is going to be Jerry Calhoun, and we are about ready to do it. As we'll be getting our first look at the Turk and El Flores, Tom Mealy will be starting out across the way. The Turk starting out on this side of the ring. Matthew Bailey by the hair, and the referee gives him a quick warning right off the bat. This is an expiration of time match. We'll be checking our time from time to time, see whether we have any of it left. Turk and El Flores against Coco Ware and Tom Bailey. Bailey, who has been coming along very, very nicely for a young fella, caught in standing side headlock. Tag on El Flores, put to the midsection, follows it up. Both the Turk and El Flores wrestle barefoot, dead. Woo! And boy, what a forearm he nailed him with from the outside. The referee saying, keep your hands out of the ring, stay in a corner. Tag again. must say that on the opening appearances of this team, being the first time we've seen them, there's Tag, Coco Ware, Coco in. We're right at the 1 minute mark, and boy, I'll tell you, the Turkenell Flores really opened it up in a hurry. Coco Ware shoved him off. Oh, how about it? Big shoulder, double, and they're both at it. Coco takes him, moves him into the center of the ring, goes for a standing side headlock, but Coco moves back into the corner, and I think the tag has been made. Yes, the referee stepped right in between, taking control nicely, and moves one out so that there won't be a double team. Coco takes one to the midsection. And the Turk again from the outside, this time no forearm. He caught him with a right fist as El Flores pushed him over in there. Coco Ware battling his way back. Big drop kick, beauty. There it is again. Boy, that guy can get up. Coco Ware sends El Flores to the corner, and Turk will be taking it over. He is much stockier of anyone in there. Coco is stocky and well-built, big, powerful leg. This Turk is some kind of heavy. Thick through the shoulders and chest, big arms on him. Referee calls for a break, and Coco helps him out. Big shoulder puts Coco down. And nice move, beautiful hip toss. Coco Ware has the Turk on the deck as he pulls into the corner and gives it over to Tom Maley. 3 minutes having passed in the first ball of action again at the expiration of time. At we don't really have too much time left. Maley up in the air. Turk carries him over, hammers him on that knee of El Flores. Turk picked him up, cranked him on the shoulder. Coco coming after him. The referee's trying to get him back. El Flores right down on Maley hard. He may have him right here. Count of one, count of two, count of three, and that's going to be it. Tom Maley caught in between the team of the Turk and El Flores. 3 minutes and 31 seconds of action. And the first ball right here of our expiration of time is Coco Ware over to help out his partner. Pretty impressive team, I'll tell you, this Turk and El Flores. They poured it to young Tom Maley. The Turk picked him right up, rousted him over his shoulder in there, held him face up, and El Flores came right down and banged him hard on the head. Turk covered him up, 1, 2, 3, and in 3 minutes, 31 seconds, the winners in the first ball of action will be the Turk and El Flores. We're going to check our time, see what's left, and we'll be back in just a moment. Action here on Wave Country Championship Wrestling in a moment. Again, a quick reminder, Thursday, March the 19th, Campbellsburg, Indiana. Now, how about Tuesday night right there in the Louisville Garden? Roy Rogers starts it out with Gypsy Joe. By golly, goes right down to Dundee in the Dream Machine, going against Wayne Ferris and Tojo Yamamoto with Jimmy Hart at ringside. And of course, Lawler going against Hart in that one-handed match in there. Billy, the big dream, I think everybody knows now, he's got no love for Hart or any of those people there.
That's right, man. It's the time why we want to see this guy in the ring. They call themselves the champions. They got the belt, so I guess that's what makes the champions. It's the Hall of Victory, Jimmy Hart. And it's an old thing when you got to fight fire with fire, that's what you need. Well, I got a fire, you can't forget, man. Jimmy Hart, you bring your family, your army, whatever you want on them, and we'll go down. So if you're going to walk all of you, standing right there, 272 pounds, and you see, brother, and you know who he is, Jimmy Hart. We'll be looking for the Garden.
Man,
rocks.
Just like I told Billy Superstar Dundee that I'm sick of Jimmy Hart. I'm sick of being put in the back seat. Watching Dutch Mantell, Wayne Ferris, Tojo Yamamoto, Gypsy Joe the Angel. I'm being put below every one of them, and I was the toughest. I've never yet lost one match in the Louisville Gardens, and all them people up there know that I am that man that walked that barbed wire fence 32,000 miles barefoot, and he still stoned gate. That lighting was red. Got a 38 foot on a 45 frame. It's not so much weight on my shoulder, but it's a lot of hell on a man's back. thing that's going to be on your brain, Jimmy Hart, because I guarantee you me and Superstar Dundee is not going to lose. We're going to fight far with far, and it's going to be a graveyard digging and a coffin bind. A long time we've been in Hart, you will be crying, because I'm sick of you, Jimmy Hart. I'm fed up with you. Blow up the top of my ugly head, and I guarantee you it's all going to come to a switching heart in Louisville.
It'll be happening right there in the garden Tuesday night. You got to be out there to see that when Dundee and the Dream get it together to go against Wayne and Tojo Yamamoto with Jimmy Hart looking on. Don't miss it Tuesday night. A one fall match, and we'll go to El Flores and the Turk. The big news today that in what turned out to be a handicap match, it'll be Wayne Ferris and Tojo Yamamoto, the new Southern Tag Champs, winning it from Bill Dundee. Tommy Rich could not be here for the match today, a very unfortunate thing. We'll be looking for Dave back. We'll be looking for you back next week. Till then, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody. The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than the station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.